look at these cars. Oh, I saw this one yesterday parked at the Deli Grill. Wow. Or I think that was maybe that one. Look how fun. Now that's a Studebaker.
It's good.
Look at these cars. Are these all Studebakers?
Yeah.
Are they?
Yeah.
I thought this was the only style.
Right, this is my wife, Yvonne.
Hi there.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Thank you for having us.
Thanks for coming. This is awesome.
1950.
Wow. Horseless carriage.
One of my styles.
Amazing.
Perfect.
Hi, nice. Nice cars. The Studebaker Club has come to DeMora Motor Car today. Look at these cars. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
This is awesome. I didn't know Studebaker made this style of a car. When did they, what year did they start doing
Studebaker? You got me. I just ride in them. Although, there is a 1917 coming.
I think the horseless carriage one, I think that's the 1915 or something.
Yeah.
Poor thing. Here, why don't you wear my sweater? Hang on one second.
It's cold today.
It is. Look at this car for St. Patty's Day. It's perfect. Here. That's what?
One of two.
One of two. The silver car is one of two cars? Why is that? Because it's so old?
Because they don't have any more around.
Is that the 1915 or something?
Probably like 32.
I've got a question for you. How'd that picture come out with who against the green car?
Is that your car?
She did. No, she didn't exactly disappear.
No, I wish her were, though.
Beautiful cars.
Yeah, they told me that this is just one of two.
Now,
they may have made another car.
Wow, one of two. Gosh.
Yeah, they could also have a low production run.
Oh. Happy St. Patty's Day.
Happy St. Patty's Day.
I don't see green on some people.
I got the green.
They might get pinched. He's got green on.
Honey, this is Frank. This is the gentleman that set this.
Oh, thank you, Frank, for setting this up.
Yeah, we're glad to be here.
We're glad to have you.
I remember when this was bumper. I used to shop here. I was a contractor.
Oh, you were. Well, we took this.
How many square feet do you have there?
Well, we have a total of 100 now.
A little warmer in here.
Yeah.
Out of the wind. Wow. A lot of people.
Yes.
Does anybody need water by chance?
Good morning. Happy St. Patty's Day.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good thing. You might have gotten pinched. This is a big club. Wow. I'm amazed. Yeah, sit in the... Or actually, we can... Leave. You can put it too much. You can keep it on.
Manufacture the cars, believe it or not. This is a 1979. This is one of our early models. Each car, as you can see, has the cut crystal on it. And the windings as well. The waterproof crystal ashtrays. This particular one of cars was the original 252 on this prototype, which I will unveil to you here. As you can see, the transformation of the take place in this car and that car. So, I'm just going to take my car and just keep seeing this.
Picture together, I'm looking.
This one's 1941.
Those white balls.
Thank you. Look at the spoke wheels. This is a 1951. And there's a 1915. This is 1917. Wow. Mom, look at that. Mom's 1917 Studebaker. Wow. More spoke wheels.
Have any kind of stuff inside?
That's got a lot of leg room in here, you know?
Yeah.
Look at the steering wheels, even made out of wood. Yeah, this is cute. What year is this?
I was looking for it, but I can't find the year.
See, this is 1922. So this group is the antique Studebaker Club, not the normal, just regular Studebaker.
That isn't the normal Studebaker, because Studebaker doesn't build cars since the 70s.
Right. But he said there's two different clubs. This club has to be after or before a certain year.
Maybe before 70, because this car is for sure is from the 60s.
Look at that little turn signal.
Probably. It's nice.
This is the St. Patty's car. St. Patty's Day.
Probably he's going to get gentleman because he has also a wheelchair.
Oh, that's, yeah, he said he needed his wheelchair. Yeah. And then this is very rare. This car is very rare. It's like two left in the world or something.
This one?
Yeah.
Wow. Which year is this?
I think 1915. The photographer knows. Isn't this like one of two that are left in the world?
That's what he claims. He said, well, he says there's a couple of others in Europe. Probably five.
It's kind of interesting, the horseless carriage. This one's pretty. Look at the little trunk, the suitcase. See the suitcase? That's their trunk.
Yeah.
Isn't that cute?
Hey.
Can't fit many clothes in that. But see, there's no back trunk.
He has a lot of space here.
Just my beauty stuff.
Just the makeup, yeah.
Yeah.
A couple of outfits, that's about it. Not many accessories. Look at this wood steering wheel. I wonder what this thing is. Oh, this is a 1918.
Yeah.
Wow. Here, I'll take one of you two.
Yes. It's insane. So that's kind of inspired me to look at that in 1940.
Yeah, so
1940,
this one you could buy now. Or pretty soon.
Problems with the discharge, the smell.
What's going on about that?
Yeah, it was making people sick in Ford. So. We've got all the that, and that car also will come all electric as well. So it truly is a negative
energy probably for the environment is really fantastic, because you're working with hemp, which is 100% recyclable. You're working with the batteries, which are new batteries. We're changing the way the industry is doing. So what you're looking at here is that we're doing a run of 25 cars with this particular artist. So in my mind, everyone says, hey, that's rolling art. She's a beautiful car. So I name all my cars after women. And the other thing is that I decided to have rolling art, true rolling art. So I went out, sought a really interesting artist. This particular gentleman's from Taiwan. He's one of the top 100 living artists. And so what I've done is I've went to the different artists and said, how'd you like to joint venture with me? So you actually get the artwork with the car. So he does the artwork and then I put it onto the car. So that's what you're looking at. So even the color palette, exactly what's into the car. Now this has a little bit of an Asian flair because these are door knockers from the Ming Dynasty. This gentleman ended up with about 60 door knockers. That's funny, I know. Especially when he told me, he said, I got those knockers. So he incorporated those into it. So these are the only 25 cars to be built with his paintings. We are truly thrilled.
From the doorway, that's what it looks like.
You see, I was down looking at what I was trying to tell me.
It is a good black pigment. I get it. It's a black. If I were to take these blacks and put it in, that's mine, it would show brown. So that is a true brown. The paint job on it, we call that lipstick red. So,
Chanel. This is the newest Beachy supercharged.
Radio delete?
Yeah. Well, that one's even crazier. That one we put a $45,000 service. So the motor, you're asking me, this is an LS motor. So we have a deal with General Motors, and we do two motors. It's equivalent to the LS3 and equivalent to the LS9.
which I can show you that vehicle. So you can see how this thing fits in here. We've got our own radiators. By doing this, this is attached to the little things like this can all fat on this. This is actually the the brown one is a 434 horsepower, about 450. Well, you get this particular car going to start off at $1 million or $1.2 million. As you get closer to the end of the car, you get
for you. You are the wife?
Yes.
Okay, do you guys get to drive these beautiful cars?
He drives them. They're too fast for me.
Okay, but you mean that you drive with him and enjoy them?
Yes, I can. I get whiplash when I go with him, but yes, I drive with him. These cars are fast. They're faster than a Ferrari.
Yeah.
Because they're very lightweight and the engine is 450 or and that's a 500 something, the new one.
They're all, when he says they keep going up and up and up.
We have a lot of dealers that sell our cars.
Yeah.
So we had a Hollywood and Beverly Hills. The Series 2 was a big 4-passenger. Then we built the Series 3, which was more of a luxurious car, but in a 2-passenger vehicle. Is there any questions about
what they sell for when you're selling?
When we opened up for sale, they started at $34,000. I sold one to Rod Stewart for $179,000 towards the end. People were buying the cars online and reselling them. Typically, they would go out the door for about $80,000, somewhere in that. The Series 2 started at $106,500, and then the Series 3 was $82,500.
What's the engine?
That is a Lincoln Mercury motor. It's a 351 Cleveland. At the time, that's what we were able to get. And it made sense for us then.
So the chassis, it's a Lincoln.
What we did is we took the car off the body.
Right.
We went to my website, by the way, you know, on motorcar.com or today.com. What we did is we took, on this particular car, LTD set and Coopers, because they're all going to the same car. Even Lincoln for a while had the same chassis. So, and that's why we kept it to a limited number, just trying to say, okay, we're going to go for this particular thing. So, it's kind of nice because we sold out within 14 months. So, it really launched the company. We went to the supercar. A little misnomer, everybody seems to think that this is, we used to steel stamp out crude sites, all the metal in this car.
These are wider.
Obviously, we set this car up to go down the road. And I've actually taken this car out and had it at 200 miles an hour.
No lift.
That's the beautiful thing about this. It wants to hug her down and go. So, of course, we put sticky tires.
Yeah.
It hugs the ground.
Any other questions?
Otherwise, it does a wheelie.
Yes, exactly what I was
saying. It's fast enough.
Every car is a little different. This car we're doing in chrome. The other cars are in black. This car, the floors are over there. We're doing No.
They can be ordered any color, though.
Yeah, but I mean, I noticed that most of them have this beautiful, you know.
Yeah, that's the art. Hood. That's the art series. This is the, just for drivers.
Oh,
for driving.
Okay. I like both.
One's like an art car collection, and this is just a car collector, you know, drivable car.
They're beautiful. They're all beautiful.
Thank you.
Absolutely gorgeous. Unbelievable.
Thank you.
Nice if your battery does happen to go dead, you don't have to go underneath the sitting right up top. It's easy to get to. You know, so just for convenience. The believe it or not, the dashboard goes in and out of this car. It goes in, it takes about 20 minutes to come out, it's 5 minutes.
Wow.
So to work on it, it's, you know, you take pride in saying, okay,
my pleasure, Captain.
If you get to Yakima, come and see us.
We will. We will. Washington State is very nice for Washington.
This just goes right on there. This in here, we don't build any rigid bikes. So this, we have a patent, so this is moving at the same time. This bike has many patents. We don't have a battery, but this actually lights up. Turn signals on. You can't even see it. It's right inside the tank. On this side is kind of set up like a brake system. This is a patent bar with a few more. Believe it or not, the furnace is there, so it's going to come down over there, so it's going to be so, because as everyone knows, they need to see what it's going to be like everyone knows. So this is just one of the bikes that we have on the that it goes through in different temperatures and heats to make sure that the product is shrunk down
all the way
and ready to go. Because if you don't, you're going to see that bleed through on your paint. Because your paint is still shrinking too. Anybody that's ever painted a car, if they tell you it's ready to go, you know, it takes 2 years, even for a waterborne paint, to cure out. In other words, to stop the chemical reaction. Right? We're a little luckier in Palm Springs, because we set out a black car and we heat at 120 degrees. It bakes at 190 and you're fine. You don't really need enough. Put it outside in the summertime.